Hello, hello.
I've got Bradley in the house today.
Hello. So we are headed out of town. We're going to go have some fun. We got the old Jeeps behind us. Super exciting. But I had to come on and do my live. So Brad and I were talking about what do we do? What should I do my live on today? And I thought, man, I'm not sure that anybody has ever heard our story as to why we chose the industry that we chose, why we chose direct sales, network marketing, social retail. There's a pretty big reason why we chose this, and it's been fun to put it into action because I'm going to make our dreams come true. But I want to go back to the beginning because it didn't start with me. So if you're on, say hello, live, do hashtag live. If you're watching replay, do hashtag replay. I want to come back. But Brad is going to share because he is the one that got us into this industry. I know, crazy, but I'm going to have him share while he's driving. So I'm going to flip the camera so he can do the talking. Okay. Hopefully you guys can hear. So, okay.
Okay.
Wait, hold on. Okay. Let me see.
I
don't like that. Okay. Go ahead, Brad.
Okay.
Hi, Dad.
So, hopefully I can do this and draw at the same time.
Yeah, just talk. Just look forward and talk. Dez, can you hear Brad?
Hi, Dez.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. So, back in about 2011, 2012, I was doing some work, some cabinet work, and I just happened to be doing some work for some people, and the UPS guy over, dropping a bunch of boxes. It was just a different vibe. You know, I've worked in a lot of people's houses over the years, and just everything about them, there was just a different vibe. They were just so happy, and just really great people. And I was kind of taken by their I spent, I don't know, a couple weeks worth of time in their home doing cabinets, and I was just really taken by the way that they were living their life, and everything just seemed really intentional. The most kindest, gentlest people I've ever met. And the wife, she really reminded me of Elka. So I find out what they in, she was in a direct sales company, find out what company it was. It was some products that Elka was using anyway. So I actually kind of pitched Elka on, you know what, like, I met these people, and this lady is exactly like you, or you're just like this lady, and I think you would be great at doing this. I think it's so fitting for you, your personality, and I just think you'd be awesome at it. I didn't really know a lot about direct sales, or networking, for that matter, at the time, but I felt like I could, I don't know, there's so much more that Elka could do and give to this world. I kind of pitched her. She was really hesitant. And
he even went to the extent of being like, babe, watch this video,
yeah,
right?
He
even did the whole third party tools thing. And I was like, this is dumb. I'd rather just buy this. So go ahead.
So anyway, she ended up joining. She watched the video. And she ended up talking to this lady, and they kind of hit it off. And anyways, this lady kind of took her up underneath her wing and tried and showed her the ropes of going to direct sales, at least with that company. That's really where our journey kind of started, was certainly Elka's journey and I guess ours.
Yeah. And this
that's
was
where
in
it started, 2011 or 12.
Yeah, it was 2011 or 12. So I
can't remember the age.
So I was still at, hi Luana, hi Steph. So that is what led us to where we were at. So prior to Pottery, for those of you that don't know, I was in the vet clinic. I was in the vet industry, and I did it for 20 years. Right out of high school, walked right into the industry, became a top head tech at a clinic in I did large animals for about 4 or 5 years. And then I had Gage and decided to go into small animals. And that was where I stayed for another 14, 15 years. And I absolutely loved it, right? You become a vet tech because you're passionate about changing the lives of pets, not because you make a lot of money. It doesn't. Now, Brad, he has been the moneymaker since we met when I was 19. I've been with Brad almost more than half my life. And so I didn't know what to do. I couldn't sell sell candles. Like, this is silly. I can't do this. I buy these things. And Nicole Ferland, she had the fifth largest Scentsy team? Fourth or fifth largest Scentsy team in the entire company. And I learned from her, and I learned exactly how I wanted to show up as a leader and build a team. I learned how to sell. I learned how to talk to people. I learned all these things, and I knew at that moment I could probably make this work. I wasn't passionate about candles. I mean, no offense, any girls out there that are number one in Scentsy, like, hell yeah. It just wasn't my jam. And I even remember to this day, I wanted to grow a team. And Nicole was like, well, just invite her over to your house, set up a display and invite her over, share with her why you and Brad decided to, you know, kind of get on board and do things. And I did. And I spent like 2 hours with this lady just for her to tell me she wasn't interested. And I was devastated. I was so hurt. I'm pretty sure I cried, and I'm like, screw this. I'm not ever building a team. Not happening. I ain't doing it. And Brad just kind of rolled his eyes, and he was like, babe, it's one person. It's one person. I was like, no, this is dumb. And it wasn't, but 2 years later, 2 years later, I kept doing it. I found Pottery. I was sitting at Boy Scouts. My sons do a non-denominational Boy Scouts years and years ago. And I was looking for jobs online that I could make $100,000 with, right? Like, who does that? I had no experience. I had nothing but a high school diploma. I had only ever been in the vet industry. I had zero other skill sets in my head, right? I realized I had a lot of skill sets, but none in my head. So I was Googling jobs, and I'm on KSL, which, for those of you that are local to Utah, it's like a local Utah news ad thing.
Classifieds.
Yeah, classifieds. And so I'm on there. And hopefully you guys can hear us okay, because we're driving. And oh my gosh, I totally forgot where I was. This is totally what happens. I forget what I'm talking about. I squirrel really, really bad.
That's because you just looked up at our happy place.
I did. I looked up at my favorite place on earth, and I can't tell you guys where it is. But, okay, so I'm sitting at Boy Scouts. It's late at night, and I am looking for jobs, right? And I scroll, and I run across Pottery, and I was like, shut the front door. This is network marketing, direct sales, but it's with pets?
Hey.
Are you kidding me? And it was insane, because I knew that this was exactly where I needed to be, was with this company, so that I could jump in and do it, right? Because I loved the industry. I knew how to sell it. I thought, man, I'm passionate about this. I could even build a team. Yay to Team Endless Possibilities, if you're out there watching. And this was really the moment that I realized that I knew exactly where I needed to be. So I went home. I blew up Brad, and Brad's like, okay, well, this is a brand new company. Are you sure you want to do this? He's like, how are you, you know, do you know anybody? And I was like, no. Well, what was funny is this one ad, it was Trisha Deming, this one ad that I found on this classifieds. I took a screenshot of it, and it got pulled that same day. So if it wasn't for that screenshot, I never would have continued. Well, maybe I would have been connected to Trisha. But anyways, I called her, and I was like, tell me about this Pottery stuff. Is it AFCO improved? I want to know the science behind all the products. Like, I need to know all this information. I need to make sure that this is, you know, a good quality pet product. Hi, Carrie. And Trisha looks at me, and she's like, I don't know. That's a great question. Let me find out. So I'm just laughing, because at this point I'm telling Trisha that I need all these questions answered. Like, I'm really seriously interested, and I need all these answers right now. And Trisha ended up telling me, can you just come to my house at the end of this month for like a get together? The founder and CEO is flying in. He wants to meet you. So is our national sales director. And I was like, yeah, I'll come. But I'm really not into the party thing. And so I tell Brad about it. Brad's like, I'd never done like party stuff before. So I get a hold of my best friend, give a shout out to Selena. Hopefully maybe you'll watch this one day. And I go to the vet clinic the next day and I slide her a sticky note and it says pottery.com. I'm like, you got to check this out. We're doing this. And she was like, what are you doing now? And I'm like, we're doing this and we're going to Trisha's house at the end of this, at the end of this month. And we're going to learn all about pottery and we're going to do it. So anyways, long story short, we ended up going and meeting the founder and CEO and the national sales director. And we went and got to kind of like have this party, right? I mean, in the beginning, Pottery was actually a party plan company. Kind of strange, right? Now we're not a party plan. We're 100% relationship building. And it was really fun because I got to spend almost 2 hours with our founder and CEO and our national sales director, Melissa Davis. And it was life changing and it was really funny. So I go home, wait, before you jump out. So I go home and I'm super excited and I vomit everything about Brad, all the products, the science behind it, how I was going to make, you know, $1 billion and just by selling these products. And Brad looks at me and he's like, babe, how do you make the money? And I was like, well, who cares about making money? What are you talking about? Like, the products are top notch and they're this and they're all natural and they're holistic and there's no preservatives and there's veterinarians that stand behind us. And Brad was like, well, how do we make the money, babe? And I'm like, I don't know. So I hurry and texted Trisha and I said, Trisha, I'm like, I forgot to ask how we make money doing this. And Trisha talked to Melissa Davis and Melissa Davis wasn't leaving until the next day. And so Trisha and Melissa Davis took Brad and I to breakfast the next day because Brad had some additional questions. I was all in, man. They fluffed me up all day long about these products. And we didn't even have pets, mind you. We had zero pets. There was no cedar. There was no tukey. There was no olive. There was nothing. And I wasn't sure if I could sell these products without having pets, right? So we ended up going to breakfast. Brad learned about the compensation plan. He got to see the bigger vision. He got to hear Melissa Davis's story. She had a wildly successive multi-million dollar drug sales company with Excel. So I knew that we were learning from the best of the industry. And okay, you can go now. But I wanted to come on and share because here I am 7 years later, Brad and I, we are creating a life that we want to wake up to. We're creating a more full-time life. Did you guys hear that? Not a full-time job. It took me years to see Brad's vision. It really did. I have had to walk through fires. I have had to face some demons. I have had to walk a lot of personal development growth in order to see my worth to be able to do this industry. Because it's super important that when you look at this industry, A, you have to have belief in the product. Right? You have to have belief in the product. You have to have a belief in the industry. Now, Brad's belief in the industry came from Nicole that he had met. He saw firsthand what this industry could do for a family. And he was inspired by that. Hi, Luana. Oh, we love you too. And it took me a little while to catch up. So here I am, 7.5 years later, belief in the product, belief in the company, and 100% finally believe in myself. And I can't wait to be number one in pottery. So if you guys have ever thought about this industry and you are looking to learn from somebody who has literally built from the ground up a very successful organization, I would love to have you come take a look to see if pottery is a good fit for you. Come to a Facebook Live. Come watch a webinar. Come meet the people in this company. I mean, you heard it. You heard it from Brad. You heard our story. You heard the belief in the company. I want to help you find belief in the industry, find belief in the product with our pet products, and find belief in you. Those are the three core things that will help you to be successful in anything that you do. You have to have belief. So I appreciate you guys staying with me all this time. It was the only time I had Brad locked in the truck where I could potentially have him participate and share his belief in the industry and what he saw pottery could do for us. We're going to be number one. We're going to create a life that we want to. Our life has dramatically changed in the last 7 years financially. I have never made the amount of money that I have with anything that I've ever done. And I will tell you that in 2019, November, I think it was November 30th of 2019, I bought my Jeep Rubicon. It was a dream vehicle that I had manifested for years and years. I'm a Jeep girl, way back from the roots. I bought it, and I will tell you that we just paid it off. Oh, let me rephrase that. I just paid it off. Never in a million years did I think that I would have the worth to be able to do something that I've never done before. But I'm here to share with you that I can show you how to do it. I know I can show you how to do it. And the skill sets that you will have, the personal development that you will learn, because it really is a personal development program with a compensation plan. I will share that at the top of the roof cups. I have had to become the person I am today to lead an empire the way that I want to lead it. So if you're interested and you've been watching this and you relate with me and you feel like you're my tribe, I want you in my tribe. I want to help you to become successful and change your life and change the lives of pets. So I love you. I appreciate you. And if nobody has told you today, I'm going to say it one more time. I love you. I love you. I appreciate you. I see you. I hear you. I honor you. And I am here today because of you. And I love that. So I hope you guys have a beautiful weekend. We're taking off with the family. You will see me though every day live, because I would not ask my team to do anything that I'm not willing to do. So we have a month-long live challenge. So you will see me every single day. So I hope you come back and watch. I love you all. Peace out like trout. Kiss all your fur babies on the snout. Have a beautiful weekend. We'll see you tomorrow.